back, Nebraska fans. It's the last day of 2020. I know it's been a hard year for a lot of us, so hope you've been able to get out a little bit, get outside, decompress, explore Nebraska, have a little fun. That's what I'm trying to do today. I'm back here at Jackson, just south of Ceresco. It's a place where I've had some luck, but today will be interesting. I've never tried to hunt when it's this snowy and cold. It snowed about 7 inches a couple of days ago, and it's about 4 degrees this morning. Snow will be really crunchy. My hands will be really cold, but you know, it's the last day of the year. I wanted to get out, make one more video this year. Hopefully you enjoy it, follow along, and then we'll see what happens next year. I've got some ideas for videos that maybe aren't even outdoors. Maybe we'll take a look at some Nebraska books, take a look at the guides coming out, the Atlas, get ready for spring, get ready for some fishing, see what else we can do. So if you have any ideas, drop a comment below. I'm eager to hear from people, see what they think, how they like this year's videos, what they'd like to see different. It would really help me out. All right, let's go tromp through some snow, see if we can scare up a pheasant or two, and otherwise just enjoy this beautiful morning. All right. All right. Like I said, it's cold out. You can see the frost on all these volunteer weeds and shrubs. Doesn't look like anyone's been out here since it snowed. Thank you.
Follow the trail. Thank you. No signs much yet, except for this trail. I haven't decided. It looks like it's deer. Yep. Deer trail here. To blow my nose here. That's better. All right, should we head into the little pond area? I was expecting to see more activity in the snow here. It really makes you think there's not much going on out here. Lots of nice places to hide out for the winter in here. these crystals great. Cattails. It's like diamonds all over the field. I don't know how well the camera's picking it up, but the sun coming up sparkles across this whole field. Oh, we have a little open water right there. Something's probably living in here, keeping it open. But I don't see much tracks going on. Let's see if I can make it across. It's really pretty. A little trickle of water right here. Don't want to fall in. Yeah, open enough for animals to come get a drink, but you know, I don't see any tracks except one deer track over there. Snow is not so crusty that a small animal wouldn't break through it. This makes you wonder what pheasants do in the winter. Do they just hunker down in the reeds? And they find another field. Little something right there. Some kind of little animal. Can't tell what. I It's nice to look around. I wonder if this is Phragmites, an invasive grass weed. Might be. I'm not an expert on that stuff, but I know it's kind of this soft, plumy grass looking stuff. I think it snowed Tuesday, so it's Tuesday, Wednesday, and then today. I've been on vacation all week, so it's losing track of the days. Been a good week for sledding. A 10-year-old and I built a sled ramp in our park next to our house on Tuesday, and then by Wednesday, yesterday, it had frozen over, and all the kids in the neighborhood were going down it. It's fun to watch out our window, getting out, doing a little snow play. We made a snow zombie. It was just like the torso, head, and arm. And then we took food coloring, painted it green with red blotches and yellow eyes. Well, there's a little track. Not sure what that is. Anyway, we're having a contest with my mom and sister who can build the best zombie. And my son and I won, so that was fun. We got $20 and a Little Caesar's pizza out of it. Something fun to do when you're cooped up in the winter. You have to make your own fun sometimes in Nebraska. There's lots of things to do. The variability of the seasons. Just as winter is becoming a drag, you get spring. And summers are really nice. Autumn's always beautiful. Sometimes lasts clear through December, sometimes not. It's not like I lived in Seattle, Washington for years. And the variability there is really low. And the extreme weather systems are like, well, you get wind storms. But I don't know if I ever heard thunder while I lived there. There's no lightning, it's just gentle rains, fogs, bone-chilling 40-degree cold, wet winters. No exciting weather. Not much variability. It gets boring, especially when it's farther north. So it's, you come home and leave work at 4 and it's already getting dark, especially if it's cloudy. Get up, go to work, it's dark. But I will say there, Junes and Julys are some of the best I've ever had. Because then it's light till 10:30 at night. And Seattle's actually one of the driest places in July. Doesn't get any rain at all. But any fight with the traffic. And every time you want to do something like this, go out for a hike, go do something outside, at least 10 other people decided to go to the same spot that you thought of. So it's not like this where it snowed 2 days ago. I come out here and there's not a single boot track. So I'm the first. I don't know, there's something to be said for getting to have a place to yourself, basically. And it's not hard to find. There's a lot of different wildlife management areas, CRP, public hunting grounds here in Nebraska. It's probably not hard to find friends in private places either. Look at that, coyote. A couple of them. Oh, get a little activity at least. I wonder if they'll see me. Shoot, are those coyotes or foxes? I think those might be foxes, sorry. I can't tell. My eyes are old and bad. Playing. My toes are getting kind of cold, otherwise I'm doing okay, but it's about time to turn back around, go back to the car. There's not much going on out here, but I came out here for a little fresh air, adventure, trying something new, show you guys what it looks like, show you all what it looks like. you know. You don't have to do it yourself if you don't want to. Let me find the good spots and the good times to go. Learn something from me, my experience, my adventures. And then hopefully get out and try it yourself. Hopefully I show you what's possible. Muskrats are keeping a hole in the ice over there. That's nice. I saw them here last time I was out hunting. All right, y'all. Time to head back down the trail to the car. Back at that tree line is where I'm parked. Maybe we'll scare something up on the way, but it doesn't seem likely. Hope you all had a good 2020. I know. None of you probably did. No one had a good 2020. But it's over. New year around the corner, we have a new chance to make things right. Brought some skis, cross-country skis, or maybe they're called like Telluride skis. I could have been skiing and hunting. That would have been fun. That's something to do for next year. What I need to do is get an ice auger. I do not own an ice auger to go ice fishing with yet. Excuse me. That would open up some opportunities for me in winter. Like, it's the last couple of winters though, there's been, I don't know, maybe a week where the lake seems to have been frozen well enough to go ice fishing. Need them at least 2-3 inches thick. 4 is better. There was a fisherman who fell through the ice of Holmes Lake on, I don't know, maybe Monday of this week. He couldn't get out. Emergency workers came. Had to like chain up, crawl out on the ice, rescue him, take him to the hospital. Turned out he was okay, but that had been a terrifying experience. Thank you. tracks. Look a little like bird tracks. But smaller birds. Well, there we go. We got something going across here. A deer. Going across there. Trust the ice down there. Whatever it was, it looks pretty small. Sun feels nice. It's gonna warm up today. I don't think it's gonna get above freezing, but it's gonna get above 4. There's my tracks going that way. Made a loop. You know, even though I didn't see, well, we saw the foxes, and that was really cool. And we saw the frost on the cattails. That was pretty neat, but I just feel better. I haven't got out here, gone for a walk, taken the gun for a walk. I don't know, there's some level of stress from being cooped up in your house, not going outside much, not getting out to do things you would normally do. Come out here, take an hour, go for a walk. You just feel that stress melt away, feel reinvigorated, ready to do something productive today instead of just sitting around scrolling on the phone, watching the YouTubes. That's what I say, that's what I mean by let Nebraska take care of you when I say that. It's out here waiting for us. Place, if you're into wildlife photography, come out. You know, if you're not a hunter, hunt with your camera. There's lots of cool things to take pictures of. Or just get out for a walk. Maybe study some biology. Find out what's living where. You can look at insects, birds, other creatures. Or botany. Look at what's growing. Identify the trees and plants and weeds. It's nice to get out and walk around, but it's also nice to have a secondary goal of something to do, keep your mind busy while it's unwinding out here. Something you're looking for, something you're learning, something you're getting better at. Trump, trump, trump across the ice. I wonder if deer ever fall in. I bet they know ice pretty well. You know what pheasants do in the winter? Drop a comment below, maybe I'll try and look it up. I don't know how active they are. Maybe they just hunker down and wait till spring. I don't know. It's always something to learn though. All right,
thanks for coming out with me today. Last day of 2020. Hope you all party like it's 2020 tonight. Make some New Year's resolutions about getting outside and doing some exploring. Pick up a new hobby, you know, try it out.